Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. I'm going to do a 3-in-1 so that you can pick and choose what you want to know more about. I'm just going to summarize and put all the links in the description box. And I'm going to start with the one that would be a follow-up to something I've already reported was, some more hand sanitizers being reported. And the reason I'm reporting them, well, I would anyway, but it's saying that in addition to the original 9 brands of sanitizer originally flagged, the FDA recently added 50 more. Many have since been voluntarily recalled by the manufacturer. CBS News reported that some of the sanitizers on the FDA's list were sold at Walmart-owned Sam's Club and BJ's Wholesale Club. So if you shop there, you need to listen up. But even if not, they're bound to be sold elsewhere. The following products made by Esk Biochem, SADCV, That's the same one I reported before. And these may be included in that 50, but I'm not sure because they're only listing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, so it's All Clean Hand Sanitizer, National Drug Code. See, that's why you're going to want to pull this up, but I will give you the names. Esk Biochem Hand Sanitizer. The next one, Clean Care No Germ Advanced Hand Sanitizer. That sounds awfully familiar. Clean Care No Germ. The next one is Lavar, L-A-V-A-R, 70, Gel Hand Sanitizer. The next one is The Good Gel, Antibacterial, Gel Hand Sanitizer. And really, folks, that's all they're good for is germs, bacterial germs. Clean Care, No Germ, Advanced Hand Sanitizer, 80% alcohol, NDC. Well, anyway, the numbers you can look up if you want to pull up this, the link on this article. The next one is Clean Care No Germ Advanced Hand Sanitizer, 75% alcohol. And the next one is Clean Care No Germ Advanced Hand Sanitizer, 80% alcohol, and the number is just different from the other one. The last one is Saniderm Advanced Hand Sanitizer. Okay, it says in addition, the FDA said sanitizers made by Grupo Insoma, S-A-P dot, it looks like a small L, D, day, it's Spanish, D-E, small letters, capital C-V, have also tested positive for methanol. And the agency has asked the company to recall the products. The agency has also asked for voluntary recalls of several other products. See a full list at this FDA website. Okay, so I'm going to stop this one here. It's not really very long, but I just wanted to start with this one because it does involve your health. If you have purchased any of these products, you need to take them back. If I don't care if your bottle's half empty, you need to get your money back so you can buy something else. Okay, so I'm going to go to this first one, and the reason I want to report this is because even though I do believe the rapture is very soon, this is something I want you to have to to share with your family members that you know aren't going, because they just make fun of you if you try to talk about it, but they're still talking to you. And maybe they'll listen to this, all right? You could at least possibly print a copy, leave it in your house if you live alone, mail it to all your relatives. All right, I don't know how much good this will do, but let me read you part of this article and why I'm telling you. The COVID-19, no vaccine needed. There is already a cure. Now listen to this. This is disgusting. Dr. Richard Bartlett, a Dallas MD who previously advised Governor Rick Perry for 7 years, has a life-saving COVID breakthrough that Taiwan, Japan, Singapore, and Iceland are also using. Now, one thing I wanted to know after I was reading this, how come the powers that be are letting them use it? Okay, I'll continue. The breakthrough is an inexpensive generic drug. No, it's not the one that President Trump talked about, which is actually helping also when you combine it with zinc. The breakthrough is an inexpensive generic drug used to help asthmatics for more than 20 years. But the U.S. and most, excuse me, I'm going to have to move just to get away from smoke. Man, I just keep running into it and it's bothering me. Yeah, I have cough variant asthma. So here it is, an inexpensive generic drug used to help asthmatics for more than 20 years. But the U.S. and most of the world's governments are using the WHO's blind acceptance of the failed China strategy. Oh yeah, how good did that work? The deaths in every state and every country could almost stop overnight if health professionals changed course immediately. For some reason, the NIH and the CDC want to act as slow as molasses, but a small number of doctors are already doing this with their patients, and they are seeing immediate success. Will it work for every single patient? That remains to be seen, but many people who have used this protocol saw immediate results. This is the same path taken by Taiwan. 24 million people live in Taiwan. Guess how many deaths they have reported? 7. Japan has 126 million, but they have had 977 deaths. Maybe people didn't go to the hospital soon enough. Singapore, 5.6 million people and 26 deaths. Iceland, 341,000 population and only 10 deaths. Now, what does that tell you? That's why I was saying, why are the powers that be letting them get away with using it? All right, this doctor and his successes, it's Dr. Richard Bartlett, has been practicing in Texas for 28 years. Governor Perry asked him to be on the Health Disparities Task Force for 2 years, and he stayed for 7 years. He is regular CBS TV health expert. That's probably why some of the doctors are paying attention to him. He is also a medical author who undertakes medical missions around the world. Dr. Bartlett says he is giving his COVID-19 patients an inhaled steroid. Now, this is the part your doctor would need to know, or your family's doctor, or whoever sees this later if you're gone, so they could call this doctor or figure it out for themselves. It's a standard asthma treatment, an inhaled steroid. Not only is this treatment working, he says, many of his patients see immediate results. For best effect, this generic medicine is administered through a nebulizer machine, not an inhaler. So it's a steroid that can be put into a nebulizer machine, which gets it into your lungs better than that steroid I was on. It's like a puffer, but you just put your mouth on it, and I forget how it worked, but it just blew it into your mouth. And the last two I had was pushing too much in and choking me. So I got out of using that. I didn't have to use it anymore. I just have to use the one you have to shake up, and, you know, you've seen people use them. That's what I have for when I get around smoke. But it leaves a lasting effect. Okay, so I'm going to end this here. And it says here it costs around $200 for a complete treatment. If you had your own nebulizer like I do, and you can buy them on Amazon, all you need is the doctor's orders to buy the medication. He also uses an antibiotic to protect from secondary infection of pneumonia, and also zinc, which fights against virus multiplication. So I would suggest everybody get on zinc. I get it, believe it or not, I get it through my denture powder. I use probably too much, according to the package, as to how much to use. I use at least twice what they tell you. And I have to, because my dentures are too big. Anyway, the point is it contains zinc, and I'm sure that's why I don't catch colds. So anyway, I'm going to end this one here, and I will link it in the description box. Now, this last one is very heavy-duty stuff. I don't know if any of you ever heard of a David Goldberg, but after he apparently made a video, and an audio file, and locked it in his safe. I'm sure the video was taken down, but someone discovered after his death, which was the day after, it says this, the video on YouTube says, the title is David Goldberg Blows the Whistle on Project Zephyr, which sounds to me, well, up here it's pronounced, in the video it's spelled Zephyr, Z-Y-P-H-Y-R. They may have misspelled it on purpose. But anyway, it says this audio file was recovered from David's safe. I'm going to mute this and just read part of it. After his death, it contains information yielded from the classified documents he was given. We believe he was murdered due to this information. Please review his previous contexts. Wow, that went by fast. Review his previous videos for more context. I say over here, David Goldberg, Secrets from Silicon Valley, put up by the channel Creative Live. So probably if you did a search, you could find more. But anyway, moving on. The audio file was recorded in early June of 2019, a few days before David's death. It was recorded a few days before his death. Now, David Goldberg's final words, classified documents, and White House memos reveal extermination plans for millions of Americans through Project Pogo and Project Zephyr. Okay, so from this point on, it's him talking. It's the audio file that was found in his safe. And the channel that's sharing this is called Robbie and Kim Sheik. And people who are going to be left behind. Okay, I got to tie this together quick. They say, I can't vouch for his authenticity, but the synagogue of Satan wants us taken out undeniably. Allegedly, David Goldberg was silenced right after making these recordings. Now, right over here is Israeli News Live. And last night I listened to a video where Yana was sharing what she got from one of her sources about what he was talking about, David Goldberg. She was nearly in tears talking about how America's worst enemy was, I think is how she put it, our best ally. And that would be Israel. He says on here, the kickoff begins when President Trump declares he is King of Israel. Now, didn't we hear something about that already? It just sounds like we did. Or that he says he will be King of Israel. Anyway, this is very interesting stuff. It's scary if you're not saved. If you are not saved and you don't think you're going in the rapture, or you don't know, they have extermination plans for about 15 million Americans, and their ones from YouTube, they have, he says, it actually has taken time. As of when he recorded this, they had about 78% done, figured out who they need to be out of the way. And I have a feeling the Lord Jesus Christ is going to take care of that for them. So they don't need to worry about it. But it won't be that many people getting raptured from America. So a lot of them are going to be political dissidents. People with guns. People that are for gun control that would actually get out and help with a rally of some sort. That kind of thing. You know, I just believe this is something worth passing on so people will know. pass it on to your family or friends that they're pro-America, pro-Israel. They need to know the truth. They need to know. That's why they don't want doctors using that old drug, that old malaria drug, to cure people that do get the COVID bad enough. They don't want it cured. And I think that doctor in Texas is getting away with it because he is mainstream media news doctor, you know, and working for the governor. He's not just a doctor practicing on his own. He's somebody, so to speak. But anyway, I'm just going to link this because it's 26 minutes. And that's 26 minutes of what I listened to. And I don't remember everything he said, but I know that it's kind of mind-blowing. If you didn't know about the rapture, you would be like, oh my gosh, am I on the list? Well, if you talk about stuff that a lot of these people are having to put a umbrella on now, they keep getting their stuff pulled. Or if you've just gotten some community guideline strikes, I don't think anybody on my channel would fall into this category, but there may be some come listen here and there. It's information worth passing on to people that might put it up, okay? And pass it on. It's, see, everything we do, they know. Every video you like, they know. Every video you make, you like, you comment on, some they're having a hard time finding some of the people. They figure out who you are by your name. See, like I go by a name different from the name they have. And most likely, this channel here that put this video up, Robbie and Kim Sheik, that's probably their name. So, like, they wouldn't be that hard to track down by their ISP address. That takes you right to where they live. Anyway, I'm going to end this now because my voice seems to be wanting to try to give out. So I'll link all three of these. And if you're interested in any of them, you can listen, you know, click on the links that you want and hear more about it. All right, I plead the blood of Jesus over this video, myself, my computer, and my internet connection. And I plead the blood of Jesus over each and every one of you and over your devices and your internet connections. And with that, I'll say, let's say it together. Pray that you may be counted worthy to escape all these things that are to come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man. And also, well, that's Luke 21:36. Remember, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. And I believe that's Isaiah 54:17. I'm pretty sure that's right. Okay, bye for now. I'll talk to you later.